these monstrous ants are in dire need of a new nest, a safe haven where they can feed their hungry young and expand their growing colony. And today, we're going to make that happen. Welcome to Aesthetic Ants. Today, I'm introducing you to my brand new Mamesia pyriformis colony, also known as bull ants or inch ants. These incredible creatures hail from Australia, and trust me, they're unlike any ants you've seen before. What makes Mamesia pyriformis so special? For starters, their size. These ants are huge, with queens that dwarf most other ant species. Their workers are just as impressive, both in size and strength. The colony structure is monogynous, meaning there's only one queen leading the colony. Over time, colonies can grow to house hundreds, even thousands of workers. They're also fiercely territorial and armed with powerful stings, so you definitely don't want to get too close. In the wild, they're found in arid regions, building nests underground using soil and debris. Their diet? Pure carnivore. They're expert hunters, feasting on crickets, cockroaches and other insects. Their large compound eyes give them excellent vision, and their powerful mandibles ensure no prey escapes. Our colony has been living in a simple tubs and tube setup with some sand as the substrate. It's a low maintenance way to raise ants. We've kept them at 22 to 25 degrees Celsius, and the colony has been thriving. Check it out, the third generation of workers is already on the way, but with more ants comes the need for more space. It is time to upgrade. For the new home, I'm using the Aesthetic Ants Medium Wide Tongue Type B Small Ant Nest. It's a tried and tested choice for bull ants. This nest has raised many successful colonies, so it's only fitting we use it for our Mamesia pyriformis. First, I'm adding a layer of sand inside the nest. This is essential because bull ant pupae need sand to spin their cocoons properly. Then, I'm decorating the outworld with a bit of sand, a fallen log, and a small rock to create a more natural, aesthetic environment. It's simple, but it's all they need. The walls had some dust, but a wet paper towel cleaned that up easily. Now it's time to connect the nest to the outworld. For these large ants, I'm using bigger tubing than normal. Larger tubing can be tricky to work with since it's stiff, but here's a pro tip. Soak it in hot water. It will become soft and more flexible, making it easier to connect. I'm also using this new clamp that's coming soon to aestheticants.com. It locks the tubing in place so the ants can't escape. Now it's time to move the ants. With soft tip tweezers, I'm carefully transferring them from the container to the outworld. It's all about precision and patience. Was surprisingly cooperative this time. Moving ants this way reduces their stress and gives me better control. With all the ants moved, I'll let them settle in. It took only about 2 hours for the first worker to explore the new nest. By the next morning, the entire colony had moved in, brood and all. Seeing them in a clear nest is so rewarding. You can finally get a proper look at their behavior. Now that they are settled in, it's feeding time. I'm using a double liquid feeder, one side for sugar water, one side for plain water. Ants love sugar water, and I didn't take them long for them to swarm it. Check out their gauze swelling as they gorge themselves, it's fascinating to watch. Inside the nest you can even see them sharing the sugar water with the queen. I'm always amazed by their social feeding behavior. But sugar isn't enough, these larvae need protein to grow. I'm feeding them house crickets. Usually I humanely dispatch the cricket before feeding it to the ants, but this time we're doing something different. We're adding a live cricket to the outworld. This is going to be intense. The larvae need protein, and if they don't get it, they'll start eating each other. We can't let that happen. The cricket is in. Now we wait. A worker spots the cricket. She's cautious but focused. The tension is high. She's waiting for the perfect moment, and there it is. She lunges, locking in her jaws and delivering a sting. The cricket's movements slow as the venom takes effect. She drags it back to the nest. A powerful display of strength and teamwork. With the ants fed and settled into their new home, this colony's future looks bright. We are excited to see how they grow from here. If you'd like to see more of this colony's journey, make sure you're subscribed. These videos take a lot of time to make, so if you're skilled at video editing and want to be part of the team, reach out at aestheticants@gmail.com. And if you're craving for more footage, head over to our EA2 Extra channel for extended clips of these ants in action. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.